For more details, we've got this report and we'll be back.
Stalling Gaza hit 258 early today as Israel pressed a ground offensive on the 11th day of a massive operation. On Thursday, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi held talks with Palestinian President Mahmoud Abbas over the ongoing Israeli aggression on Gaza as Cairo pushed regional efforts to broker a new ceasefire deal. During their encounter, Sisi affirmed that Egypt would continue its efforts to reach a ceasefire in Gaza and said that Egypt would offer all kinds of support to the Palestinian people and the leadership. The head of state called on the Israelis and the Palestinians to show flexibility to end the bloodshed in the enclave. The two leaders exchanged points of view regarding the Egyptian initiative to end the ongoing development and the latest developments in the occupied Palestinian territories. Sisi and Abbas agreed on the necessity of an immediate ceasefire based on an Egyptian plan to stop the conflict that has killed at least 240 Palestinians since Israel launched Operation Protective Edge on July the 8th. They mulled holding a bonus conference to rebuild Gaza. Abbas met in Cairo on Wednesday with Hamas deputy leader Musa Abu Marzouq, who insisted on changes to the Egyptian truce plan, including guarantees on opening border crossings to the besieged Gaza Strip. The initiative called for a return to an Egyptian broker 2012 ceasefire that ended 8 days of fighting and loosened border restrictions on goods for the blockaded coastal enclave. Israel initially accepted the initiative by Egypt but later intensified its airstrikes after Hamas rejected the plan, saying it had not been consulted.
Welcome back. And just to continue in the same issue, according to President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi's orders, Prime Minister Ibrahim Mahlad and Minister of Health and Population a visit to six injured Palestinians receiving treatment at Al-Zaytun Hospital in Cairo. Premier Mahlab said that political leadership exerts its utmost effort to contain the situation and stop bloodshed in Gaza, calling on everyone for ceasefire to allow Egyptian aid into Gaza. He added that the cases are stable. So, as a whole, how do you read this situation?
That Egypt will support Palestinian people as long as whatever happened between us, we will give them support, and the injuries will be have their medical issues at our hospitals until this period of time passed. I know that it's about 2 weeks that the bloodshed at Palestine, but Egypt will prevent the permanent support to Palestinian
people. The fact that Israel launched the ground offensive in Gaza late yesterday, maybe this is another issue.
Yes.
Especially that Hamas still, they continue and they say they are ready for them and they will continue the fight.
How they will fight, we should see that from the beginning that they are facing Israeli people. But even if in the coming days also there will be those bloodshed at the coming days, especially America is fully supported what is Israel doing, and they have got the support from America and Obama at his last speech. So the coming days also will not be will be full of the bloodshed too.
Right. Actually, as we mentioned, that talking about the civilians, this is the main issue, because even leaders of Hamas, they are not in Gaza. So the point is, we're talking about children, we're talking about women, Palestinian civilians, they are just dying every day, and I don't know.
Most of them are children and young children and young ladies and women, as you said, and old men too. And they are killed in no humanity even, you know, it's bloody and bad scenes of killing them, and especially the children of Gaza. How come, and not even killing, and they are best part of them. Yesterday, they killed four Palestinians, four children at the school too. So those scenes of killing those children, we should all over the world. You know, there are some demonstrations in different countries supporting Palestine, not only the Middle East. So we should monitor our that, and even if, as we are Arabs or Middle East, not support Palestine by only as citizens. I'm not talking about as country or by political figures. I'm talking about Egyptian citizens, maybe different Middle East countries, not supported by Facebook status or anything. Just do something that will support Palestinian people, regardless of everything what is happening at the beginning from Hamas. Don't see Palestinian people as only Hamas.
Well, let me move on to a left newspaper to take on another headline. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi received a message from Kuwaiti's Emir Sheikh Sabah al-Ahmad al-Sabah on Thursday afternoon, delivered by Mazou al-Ghanem, head of the Kuwaiti National Assembly. Al-Ghanem said that he hopes Egypt will succeed in its upcoming parliamentary elections. Al-Ghanem also thanked al-Sisi for considering the Gulf region security as part of Egypt's own interests. For his part, Sisi asked Al-Ghanem to deliver his greetings and appreciation to Sabah and Kuwait for supporting Egypt in its quest to restore its role as the region's leader, according to the spokesman for the Egyptian presidency, Ihab Badawi.
It's greeting from our president.
Just as you mentioned in the beginning, it has to do with Egypt in the region, back to its normal.
Yes.
Afro Legal Huraya newspaper, head of Cairo Appeal Court Counselor Ayman Abbas and head of Presidential Elections Commission, PEC, said they were very keen on Egyptian expatriates' participation in the upcoming parliamentary elections. The PEC official spokesperson, Medhat Idris, said the meeting between head of the Appeal Court, Abbas, and the Assistant Minister of Foreign Affairs, Abbas al-Safia, aimed at reviewing preparations of foreign ministry and consulates for the parliamentary elections.
Preparation for the parliamentary elections is very important in the political campaign of the candidates, and how the candidate, this is political marketing that we should talk and discuss. And the campaign of each candidate and the program is very important this time. We should see different programs offering different promises to citizens in order to achieve. And the preparation should be full of transparency. Even the election process later on also should be transparent to all citizens. This is very important, and we should work the day after Ramadan finishes, inshallah.
As you mentioned, this is now the time of the exact time for political marketing.
Yes.
Because, you know, we need to understand again the real role of the member of the parliament, because, you know, in the past, still people are talking about some individual issues in different districts, in different places, but we need to understand what is a parliament, what is the real job description of the member of the parliament.
He's a political figure who's elected by people in his own region, and those people of that region, he promised them by some promises that will serve them their place and their work and everywhere. He's the key between them and the government in order to achieve what they want. So he offered them his problem, his promises, his way, his he offered even himself as a candidate for them to be that key between them and the government in order to achieve what they want in something called electoral program full of bad promises. The coming period, I think the coming parliamentary elections is not only the candidate. Years ago, the candidate go for elections in order to have the title that he's a member in parliamentary elections only. But now it's responsibility, because it's not like before anymore.
The parliament this time is going to be different.
Totally different, not as before, even at 2012. So this time is the parliament at 2012 was, I can't believe that this is was our parliament and parliamentary members. So this time and the coming